Anyway, Jake said, I was on Springer one time. I was sort of the apex of my, 15 minutes of fame. My mom was like, Scott, why do you want to go on Springer? I was like, 50 bucks. Anyway, I got this new material tonight. There's a certain law in the universe that only applies to me. It's like, the law says, Scott, you shall never date a girl age appropriate for yourself. But this, that brings up some problems, of culture and generation. So it's like, I was pleasuring my girlfriend from behind, and I noticed she started texting. Fuck texting. And I was performing very adequately. And my phone, lights up. And I was like, that's her. She just texted me. Hey, DCIM, smiley face with the little, wink. Is it a wink or is bloody eye or something? I don't know. Goes sideways. So I didn't even think about too much. And I sort of finished up my business. She's like, hey, watch it. I gotta text you about that. DCIM. What? Don't come in me. Ah. You could have just said something. Because I thought you were saying, Dwarves Club Amelia Marcos. Trying to sex me up with that sexy talk. And it totally worked. Again, you gotta use the text things that I like, that I understand. And for me, I always use DCMA, don't come in my ass. Or SMAA, no NGGD. Spit in my ass, ain't no goddamn romance. I use that every day. So anyway, I'm a very sexually adventurous person, and I won't not do something just because I think I might not like it. I'll try something once because you never know. It might be a doorway into a whole new thing. Yeah, but a lot of stuff that requires special equipment and leather suits and all and just a lot of things. So that's why I've never tried necrophilia. Because, unless you own a funeral home, it's just shovels and digging and, it's just too much trouble. But I'm not going to say no. But if I'm going to do it my first time, I've got, my birthday wish, that I'm going to, and I'm such a star fucker, too. I'm going to dig up and fuck Ronald Reagan's eye hole. But the reason why I'm not going to do this is I'm afraid I'd catch Alzheimer's. Now, I'm not a doctor or a scientist. I'm pretty sure you can't catch Alzheimer's from, retarded, decayed brain juice out of Ronald Reagan's head. But, you never know. It could happen. And I know that, not so much for me, because I wouldn't know. I'd have Alzheimer's. So I just wouldn't even know. But, I'm thinking I would certainly pass it on to somebody else, after a while, and because I'd forget I had it, of course, Alzheimer's. And it would just rage into a flame through the stripper, daddy issues, and midget community. And I wouldn't even know, couldn't even enjoy it because I'd have, again, Alzheimer's. And then they'd track down patient zero, and they'd dig up the body of Larry King to come interview me. And I couldn't even enjoy it. I'm such a media whore, I couldn't even enjoy my interview. Because he'd be asking me questions, I'd be going, well, there you go again. Well, fuck. But I got this figured out though. I'm going to memento style, right on my arm. Now I'm sure that CNN's not going to let me drop any F-bombs. I made skull love to Ronald Reagan's stupid face. The bitch loved it. Alzheimer's! Alright, now it's Christmas. I'm gonna leave you with a Christmas poem. Santa went to Los Angeles. He walked down Sunset Strip. Santa longed to learn to dig that heavy metal scene. Santa knew he was out of touch with all those boys and girls. I don't want no wooden duck. I want some bondage toys. Molly was no longer happy with her Barbie and her Ken. He wanted to go to the poison show where he could learn to sin. Billy was no longer happy with his Disney flick. He wanted leather pants to wear on his throbbing dick. But Santa went to metal show to see where it was at. But they wouldn't let him in the door, he wore no cowboy hat. Well, this passed off Santa, as you might already know. He needed him some metal clothes to get into the show. So Santa, he went down to the decadent boutique. He bought himself some snakeskin boots, a-looking mighty chic. And Santa trapped a wrestler belt around his big old gut. He was feeling confident he could fuck a metal slug. Then on top, a 10-gallon cowboy chapeau, one with feathers round the brim to get into the show. But then Santa saw a sign on the wall, tattoos and piercings that extolled the one and all. So Santa jumped into the chair to get his nipples done. It wasn't long until he found that pain was lots of fun. But Santa, he really wanted to feel it on his dick, a metal rod through the head, tattoo saying, "I'm Saint Nick." Yeah, the kid's gone, right? So Santa went to the metal show and poison was the band. Sluts had come from miles around with a band fucking band. Santa met a metal slut, she offered him cocaine. He shot himself a mainline and even hit the vein. Santa the metal slut went to the Ritz Hotel. She tied him to his bed of pain and beat him. It was swell. But Santa, he got really drunk at slamming real cheap beer. When he woke up, he shot the girl and molested his reindeer. Fuck Dasher and Dancer and Prancer and Vixen. Comet and Cupid and Donner and Blitzen. But Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer,
reindeer,
sure to make a
tasty stew,
and just for added flavor, Santa threw the bitch into all of the other reindeer. Used to laugh and call him names, now they're just as dead as he is. Part of Santa's necrophilic games. So Santa went to GIT, he plays in all the bars, and sold his soul to Satan to become a heavy metal star. Merry Christmas, everybody. King's in tomorrow night.
Not once ever in my days did I think that Scott would ever finish a set by saying Merry Christmas, everybody.